China has rapidly grown to become the world's second largest economy. In 2017, its GDP exceeded $12 trillion. While strengthening its influence over the global economy with the One Belt, One Road Development Initiative, China is also actively transforming its domestic industrial framework and developing next-generation industries. Some experts believe that it is only a matter of time before China surpasses the U.S. Chinese President Xi Jinping began his second term with popularity rivaling that of Mao Zedong. At the 19th National Congress, held in October 2017, he stated his international goals as General Secretary of the Communist Party. Xi's speech addressed China playing a leading role in the world. As China seeks to become the world leader, the mindset of its citizens has begun to change. This episode asks young Chinese about how they view their country's future. The Chinese capital of Beijing. It is known as the location of numerous famous universities, which have become alma maters of countless political and economic leaders. Wu Dao Kao is an historic college district located in northwest Beijing. University students from all over China gather at a particular apartment in the district. 706 Youth Space was established in 2012 in a single large room of the apartment. It was built by young people who wanted to create an open space for students. The facility has a free library and meeting areas, and events are held every day. In China, citizens need to obtain permits from the police to hold a meeting. But 706 has its own strict rules to keep heated discussions going. On this day, a reading was held regarding political philosophy.
与世界相处，我们还是要遵守世界的这种法律规则的。 具有这种道，它法律啊，政治本身它就应该具有道德属性，不能随便说撕毁就撕毁了嘛。
嗯，
因为我们常常说现在的生活是一种霍布斯主义的，那种利维坦不是，霍布斯主义就是为了实现政治可以说谎，可以玩弄人民，可以玩弄敌人，实际上它是不道德。
本身现实来说是比较矛盾的，因为现实就是刚才说好的法律，即使是好的法律也是跟道德是有矛盾的，不可能，现实来说很多时候是不可能，就是有冲突有矛盾，而且是不可调和的。结合现实的说的话，其实还是有很多地方可以讨论，就甚至是可以去批判一下的，我觉得。
This rare space where strangers can freely discuss any topic has faced the threat of closure numerous times.
这个出来的话，杂志会不会疯掉？怎么说呢？我觉得，现在的状况其实有点外强中干，就是它其实是内需。
我觉得其实领导者这个东西吧，他之所以是个领导者，是因为他自己有，就是有能力解决了国内的这些问题，然后他才会说把更多的资源就是放到国际的这个。平台上面，我觉得如果是罔顾国内一些群体和一些现实的问题，然后我们夸大自己说去谈我们要成为某个领域领导者，我觉得这是就是不太好的。嗯，
而且你要成为 leader， 你要消耗很多国力。就是中国，像中国人口那么多，自己国家的问题都没有得到彻底的解决，就如果在外耗的话，其实就对国家。不是好事，我觉得就是
时代的这个进步，可能大家就是这个年轻人也好，他们也都不安于就是说我要去温饱，而是更多的是考虑说我对为这个社会或者为这个国家我能做什么。
我觉得中国一定会成为这样的领导国。
706 was launched by 12 university students, but only two are still involved.One of them is Liu Biao. He is determined to continue protecting this space while attending graduate school.
当发生一个社会上的事件的时候，除了传统上的大家在朋友圈里转发一下，自己发表一下意见，好像只有我们提供了这么一个更包容的、更可以让你讨论的公共空间。
其中有没有经历过什么压力啊，或者是说受到外界的干扰这样子呢？
有，但是呢我不知道好不好说，没事儿哈。像比如说有的话题，比如说像台湾话题就非常敏感，因为中国解决台湾呢叫台湾 question， 不能叫台湾 problem， 但是呢年轻人来讨论它怎么解决它，或者把台湾的一些想法思想引进大陆来，会不会对整个国家一些大的方略上有造成影响呢？像讨论这些话题，台湾话题、香港话题，这些都是比较敏感的。
当时为什么会开始这个706？您的初衷是什么？
当时可能一方面出于一个好玩，一方面呢也是对这个教育，就是传统大学教育感觉到有一种窒息啊，或者觉得太单调的这种感觉，特别是呢那个同学们也缺乏这么一个集体的空间，缺乏一个公共讨论的这样一个场所。
Recently, foreign students have been visiting 706, thanks to word of mouth, in order to have honest discussions with Chinese students.
我想教他。
China has achieved startlingly quick economic growth since its open door policy in 1978. Its GDP has grown over 200-fold in the past 40 years. Economic growth was supported by excess laborers in rural areas who moved to cities in order to provide work in construction and factories. The cheap labor needed for mass-scale infrastructure and garment factories had been China's greatest strength. But as infrastructure develops, migrant workers who come to large cities from rural villages can only get manual labor jobs, such as lunchbox delivery personnel. As online businesses and service providers took off, the word delivery personnel came to symbolize dangerous and demanding jobs. Delivery to one home only earns a worker $1. If goods are not delivered on time, there is a fine. That's why delivery men work hard to deliver goods on time. According to a domestic media survey, 40% of China's 7 million plus delivery personnel have caused traffic accidents. Collectively, they have caused many traffic accidents involving injuries or deaths. Tian Mingzhu migrated to Beijing from Shandong province. After trying a number of jobs, he purchased his own motorcycle and began working as a delivery man around a year ago. His wife and two children live in a rural area. When his income stabilizes, Tian has promised to bring them to Beijing to live with him. Tian lives in an old building in downtown Beijing, where many migrant workers reside in inexpensive, illegal housing. Currently, the Chinese government is eliminating illegal housing in Beijing to reduce the number of residents. It says the goal is to create a functional and pleasant landscape suitable for the nation's capital. This entire area is scheduled to be razed. Tian has been told to vacate the apartment within a month. He shares this 20 square meter room with another delivery man. Rent is $95 each, a monthly rate that can no longer be found almost anywhere in Beijing.
是变化挺大的，这经济发展太快了，这钱都不如以前好使，以前100块钱能养活一家人，现在100块钱只能够一个人吃饭，你觉得这个北京政府对咱外国来说公平吗？不太公平，就像这摩托车来说。 北京三环以内，只能这个京A的牌子进，京B的牌子都进不了。京A的牌子都是以前老北京人最早的牌子，现在都没有京A的那个摩托车牌。我是比较喜欢吃辣椒，我经常在外边买辣椒。
哎，你觉得中国的现在的发展，你觉得有没有可能成为世界上最先进的国家呢？非常有可能，可能性非常大。为什么？因为中国人人多。Tian
plans to work during the Chinese New Year without a break, in order to earn even a little more money. Before he can welcome his family to Beijing, he first must deal with how to find a new home.
们是一个不像别的国家一样，我们是一个有历史传承的、有5000年文明的一个国度。
作为中国人吧，我觉得现在我们国家比较安全吧，就比较安定吧，这个是让我觉得就非常舒服的。
中国变化太大了，回来一回好像就变化一回。你要在美国，你不拿着钱包，光拿着手机不现实。你在国内拿个手机就可以。从这方面来说，可能比世界的其他国家要强。
基本上刷什么都是微信啊、支付宝呀、什么的。嗯。
当你发现你手机不在的时候，你有什么心情？
绝望。那一天会很绝望，你知道吗？然后就感觉整个人都不知道该干什么了。
我觉得很多地方都挺好的，科技啊，我觉得这个中国的发展速度啊，各方面我觉得都会越来越好。我觉得包括各种的社会福利啊，我觉得都会越来越好，我觉得啊。
China embraced fintech earlier than other countries. Now mobile payment has taken root.Smartphone usage is almost ubiquitous, with more than 90% of city dwellers owning one. With just about everyone now using smartphones, the number of IT-related firms has exploded. One company chooses to do business outside of China and is gaining massive support. Newborn Town, an app development company,has 600 million users, mainly in Southeast Asia. It sells software in over 100 countries and now employs 400 people, though it started with just 3. Their hit product is the Solo Launcher, an app for the home screen.Its most unique feature is the fast processing speed and the numerous personalized settings. The app has continually been improved based on feedback from users in various countries. Newborn Town CEO Liu Chunhua first began doing business outside of China to differentiate his company from rival firms.But as he expanded business overseas, he came to see China's increasing influence on the world.
互联网走向海外啊这样一件事情的时候，啊叫不自觉的就发现哈，啊我们高度匹配了啊这个高度匹配了很多宏观的政策和方向，这是什么意思呢？比如说我们的很多用户在东南亚、中东，过去呢。叫做 copy to China， 那现在呢叫做 copy from China， 以前 copy to China 就是把硅谷模式搬向中国。
China has rapidly grown to become the world's second largest economy. In 2017, its GDP exceeded $12 trillion. While strengthening its influence over the global economy, China has rapidly grown to become the world's second largest economy. In 2017, its GDP exceeded $12 trillion. While strengthening its influence over the global economy, With the One Belt, One Road Development Initiative, China is also actively transforming its domestic industrial framework and developing next-generation industries. Some experts believe that it is only a matter of time before China surpasses the U.S. Chinese President Xi Jinping began his second term with popularity rivaling that of Mao Zedong. At the 19th National Congress, held in October 2017, he stated his international goals as General Secretary of the Communist Party.
This new era is our constantly moving toward the world stage,
在来纽约之前，我有在日本的东京和英国伦敦有工作过，然后我觉得其他的一些比较成熟的大城市呢，虽然说在有一些方面具有一些优势，但是相对比来说，反而在一些基础设施啊，还有一些对新生事物的接受能力还比较落后。
中国的企业，它现在呢是有全球化的视野，并且呢在拓宽自己的这个影响力。这也体验了中国的一个文化的软实力吧。
But a student who had been listening silently offered a different opinion.
如果我们把领先就定义成第一的话，那中国还没有达到一个领先的地位，无论是从经济总量还是人民生活的幸福指数都没有达到第一的位置。我想探讨的是，中国未来要追求什么？是一种领导力，是一定要成为第一吗？我觉得并不一定是这样的。
就是现在我们中国已经很有地位，那我在想说这会不会只是一件因为徒有其表的事情，各种的农村地区包括北就是东北地区啊，像西北地区的这样一些农村地区，其实跟10年20年之前就是那种破落的程度并没有真正的发展，并没有得到真正的开发，那这个跟西方比起来，他们的城市跟农村的差别度是非常小的。
一个国家的发展，它离不开所有国民的支持，所以我觉得，在当一个国家就是国民都民不聊生的时候，一个国家想要成为一个比较超级大国或者是有领导性国家，这个是不可能的。其实中国不仅是有这个贫富差距问题，资本主义国家包括美国也很强烈这个问题。比如说我们会看到纽约，我们在纽约留学会看到非常多的流浪汉。
大家都知道，就是之前我们中共说这个为中华之崛起而读书。然而如今的我们有了中国作为我们这么强大的后盾，已经有了这个平台，那我们其实承担的是更大的责任。
在这里的发达程度，或者大家刚才讲生活的便利程度，这些微观细节，这还真不一定比国内做得好。但是很明显，跟国内不一样的就是这里的确是有来自世界各国的学者，还有各种各样年轻的这些学生。看一下历史，在之前的话，比如说在19、20世纪之间的时候，那时候美国作为先进国家，有点类似于现在中国的这个位置。如果中国能够有它自己的贡献的话，这一点可以超越当初美国在世有台的表现。所以对我们来讲，借鉴这个意义是一个很好的开始。
Until 2002, only 15% of Chinese students who studied abroad returned to China. Now, 80% return to their home country and land jobs. These students also plan to find work in China. In downtown Beijing, where Tian lives, many residents are being evicted. And there are fewer and fewer people in the neighborhood. And Tian has yet to find a new home.
如果觉得要改善自己的生活，你觉得应该做些什么呢？
没想过。中国人那么多，搬不过来，只能靠自己。就像我们这在北京是外地人，回到老家还是个外地人，经常在外边，很少在，也就是过年过节的时候在家待一段时间，这就是他们很多人说的 在北京是外地人，回到老家还是个外地人。我们也经常抱怨啊，说什么对外地人不明，就是不想让外地在北京待。说是这样说，其实也我们这样抱怨也不完全对，也有很大一部分是我们自己的原因，毕竟是北京首都嘛。
孩子们想什么？
想，每次打电话和我媳妇视频的时候，孩子抓着手机都不放手。别人跑九个小时，那我们就干十个小时、十一个小时，多跑几个小时吧。现在天冷，晚上也不怎么跑。要是过完年天暖和一点以后，晚上能跑到凌晨两点。努力吧，争取早点把他们接回来。
Tian says that he plans to launch his own company 2 years from now. He equates continuing to be a migrant worker in this rapidly changing country with being a second-class citizen. President Xi Jinping has stated that the day will come when China plays the most important global role. Its economy continues to grow, along with its worldwide influence. In what direction will China's leadership steer the world? And how will its relationship with other countries change? Only time will tell.